Hello, everyone. Brandon Carey is here once more, and we are about to wrap up Sly Cooper Honor Among Thieves. This will be the last episode, because we are on the last episode. Now we've got our whole crew, including Dimitri, who, for some reason, we didn't really get to know a whole lot in that episode we were supposedly recruiting him in. But this is it. We have got our full team, and now it's time to break into the Cooper Vault and try to get our inheritance back from the malevolent Dr. M. So without any further ado, let's get started.
All these memories, they just bring me back to the same place. Getting crushed to death in the fist of some genetics experiment gone wrong. Not the way I thought I'd go out. Shame, really. Now that we've got this big gang, more like a pack of misfits. Either way, we'd become a team. We had some real potential there. Could have pulled off some big jobs.
Shame, Sag.
We were so close. The door to the Cooper Vault was opening. But that Dr. M, if there's any justice, he'll get his. I just wish I had seen what was in there. A stockpile of my family's accomplishments. Would I have measured up? What would I contribute? Would my father have been proud of me or ashamed?
Oh, no.
Funny, but here I am at the end, and suddenly all I can think about is what a coward I've been towards Carmelita. I never took the next step. Looking at Bentley and Penelope, it's clear what life is about. If Carmelita was here, I'd tell her straight out how I feel and quit playing around. Put our professional differences aside and see if we can make it work. But that'll never happen now.
No, it won't.
Can't take this crushing. Just let the pain stop.
Well, this was an early end of the game. Stream's over. Have a good day. Oh, they actually just name it the title of the game. Well, Sly's dead. Stream is over. Have a good night, y'all. Remember to wear your mask, social distance, wash... Oh, wait, we're still going? What are you doing here?
Lieutenant Brock, get your squad together. We're about to see some action.
Yes, ma'am.
They could have done some audio balancing here to make it so that you could hear them more than you could hear the fucking lightning storm in the background. Brief the game already. Oh, okay, that's what happens.
It's unstoppable.
Nah, I just gotta shoot enough times. That's all. Gotta make sure I get hit by my own team. Ah, there we go. Now we can cross. When are we able to cross? It is amazing just how much stronger Carmelita is than every other character in this game. She just wastes fools.
Hey,
Okay. So much power in this little pistol of hers. God damn. Wasting that fucking giant ass mutant.
You harpy wits. Why are the police invading my home?
I'm here to see that justice is done.
Justice? I'm the victim here, defending what's mine from thieves.
Looked to me like you were attempting to murder that man.
That man, please, you know this is sly, Cooper. You're as transparent as you are narrow-minded.
Cooper is a criminal. I'm here to bring him and all lawbreakers to justice.
I'm no lawbreaker. This was all self-defense.
First things first. Put Cooper down and we'll talk terms.
I just noticed that Carmina has three fingers.
As far as I can throw you. Although I can throw you a long, long way. Go and smash that woman. Crush her bones to paste and toss her in the sea where no one will ever find her. Now to find that king. I can't believe this idiot just brought it to me. He looks just like his father, and he's just as dead.
Sly! He's over here! He's still breathing! He's alive!
Yay! We're not over, we're not done yet! We still have a game to play.
Get you back to the ship and patch you up!
We're using this ship from the pirate level, I just noticed that. Holy shit.
Suffered a major concussion. If he were up and about, I'm sure he'd want us to retrieve his family cake.
There is definitely some audio balancing issues here.
Legit, eh, my main man, bro?
Won't be that simple. That's an electromagnetic buoy. Dr. M has set him up all around the island to snag approaching metal boats. We just lucked out that we came here in a wooden ship.
She's right. Get too close and your diving gear will magnetize to it. That's an excellent idea, Guru. You're the only member of the team who doesn't carry metal equipment. If you can convince some of the local sharks into joining you in an attack, it might be enough to break the buoy.
There we go. And
jump
now... Where am I supposed to go? Oh, that there we go. There's our marker. I was wondering where the marker was. What the hell? We need a fucking bunch of sharks or not? This is such an strange objective.
You'll need to jump off and get on top of the buoy to activate it. That'll drive those sharks into an attack frenzy. Nice work. Find some more sharks and keep at it.
Okay. So, we're just trying to get a bunch of sharks to attack. There we go. This is definitely a mini game. Aided by nature. Okay. Looks like this is an exponential increase. So there was one, and there was two. Alright, and now let's get the next part of this horde. And this is three. I mean, this is a pretty simple mini game. Nothing too complicated. And there should be one more packet to this. The last pack. There you go. I don't have a whole lot to say about this. It's just another Goober mini game. Nothing too complicated. But also, to be honest, not particularly interesting. Oh, okay, just throw it in my face. And there are my last four Sharkies. One. Two. Three. Four. And now to bring them all over. And we're almost there. I think we're gonna get one of these for every one of the new crew. And that should be all 10 sharks. So that was the Guru segment.
For the job.
Don't
talk like that. No one else could have got the cane off that magnet. You're a credit to the team. Just leave your shark friends behind. They freak me out.
That's the job complete. So you've done Carmelita. You've done the Guru. Dimitri is up next.
Why? You wanted me to prep you for the mission.
Oui. The turtle dude makes sounds for les scuba. There you go, baby. Dimitri al natural. Woo! Your plan! You work to perfection!
My plan to get you alone in a swimsuit?
Come clean, my lovely, and play your cards straight. These are dangerous waters.
This is pretty good character work, though. I will say that.
Okay, first, get over yourself. Second, get over yourself. And third, jump into that water and find Slice King. It's the key to the Cooper Vault. You can't lose it.
So glad for such sweetness. I die, baby. I die for the love.
prepare for the second of two Dimitri sections in the entire game.
Grab the cane. I'm detecting some of Dr. M's creatures swimming towards it. You need to dodge their pictures with some strong swimming. Hold down the L1 button to stroke hard. Make sure you don't run out of stamina or you won't get anywhere fast.
And this is nothing at all to do with the previous diving section. It's a wholly different minigame with a similar control scheme. Which is honestly kind of hilarious. Weird. This is such an odd mechanic. Lebo doesn't even know Dimitri's name, just keeps calling him Diver. Come on, he's almost dead. There we go! That was Dimitri feels... clunky is the right word, Darabian. He feels like such an odd afterthought. Like, they needed a character to put in that slot, so they just made two missions, put Dimitri in there, and said, here's your fifth character. Here's your fifth new character. It's so odd. He only gets two sections in the entire game. We will never play as Dimitri ever again.
Slow down. Remember rules 1 and 2, both of which told you to get over yourself.
Book before my magnificence. Yum, yum. Give me some.
I'm gonna check on Bentley. You have fun being you.
You have fun being you.
Jack to the Iverson, baby!
Even his actual, I was thinking about this. I was thinking about this in the middle of writing the stuff for last week.
He should be back in bed after the thrashing he took. Another blow to the head and your brain could snap.
Quit your worrying. I feel fine. Did Dimitri find my cane?
No. Dr. M managed to get away with it.
Then we gotta go.
You're going nowhere, pal. Any attempt on Dr. M or the Cooper Vault will be impossible with these radar towers linked to the missile turrets. Wait a second, Padel, have you completed that work we talked about on your RC car?
Yeah. Oh, I see where you're going. That'll work. Smash the drones, siphon their power, and fry the tower's matrix.
Perfect. Let's get your car onto a drone patrol pipe.
Not to be too obvious in exposing my ignorance, but what in the world are you two talking about?
Explaining it would include a lot of multisyllabic words. I could just show you.
Bring on the demo.
Pandakin, can you launch my RC car to that pipe?
With the fireworks, it will fly as the bird.
Definitely a little awkward in the animation front there, but, you know, I like it. Alright, so we're basically doing like a little combat racing, but not really. But with Dimitri, I was thinking about, because I, in case you guys don't know, when I post this to YouTube, I do write a little bit about the experience. And something that I really didn't notice until after I started reviewing the footage from last week is that despite it being Dimitri's recruitment mission, Dimitri is barely in it. Like, Dimitri almost does nothing in Bloodbath Bay, despite the fact that it is supposedly his loyalty mission. Oh, so that's what happens. So it's strange that we don't really actually... Like, that, the entire point of us going there is, in theory, to recruit him, but it ends up being far more about Bentley and Penelope, which is probably the right call, writing-wise, because they are part of, like, the... Like, the tension that Penelope produces between Bentley and Sly is part of the main thread of the story. But it definitely, it is a little strange. Because even in his own mission, Dimitri's not even the star. And that might be why Penelope ends up getting the most, like, love from fans. Out of all of the characters they introduced here, because she's the one that gets the most actual screen time and development as a character compared to Guru. Like, you don't, like, Guru doesn't get a character because he doesn't really need to have one. He's just there for more facilitating Murray's character development than doing anything on his own. Come on. And the Panda King does get, like, his arc with Sly is probably some of the best stuff in the game, but Penelope is the one that people really think about more than anyone else, probably because she has.
Number two,
you're the queen of Radar Tower Demolition.
A lot more, like, there's a lot more to her character than the other, like, the other new characters. Although, I guess Dimitri's actually a big fan favorite, too. But that's because, like, he's had two games. And I guess you could say that Dimitri's arc is over the course of... Because you see him in episode 1. So I guess the argument you could have there is that... Because you see him in episodes 1 and 3... That he gets that time to be there before you actually recruit him. So he doesn't quite get the Naoto problem from Persona 4. But it kind of does get the Naoto problem from Persona 4 at the same token. Come on. Come on! That was a rude game. Just... This is hard. Need one more and we are all set. We are golden. Got it. Unfortunately, now we have to do a whole new lap just to get to the next section. At least we don't have to actually worry about running it anyway, so we can actually be a bit more deft at avoiding shots. I say as I get shot. And that's Penelope's section, so we've gone through three of our five new characters. Still got a... No, we've gone through four, actually. You only have Panda King left.
I've rested long enough.
You sure?
This is my legacy we're fighting for. You think I want to sit this one out?
Understood. The biplane launcher, although untested, should get you a lot. It's gonna be tough up there.
Be tougher down here watching others fight my battles for me.
To disable the turrets, you'll need to destroy their sensor bank. Unfortunately, it's only exposed for a short period after a missile is launched. Nice shooting. Good thing Penelope took out those radar towers, or the sky would be thick with guided missiles all heading for you. You're out of ammo.
Right.
Dr. M is sure to keep plenty on hand.
I forgot there's no limited ammo for this. I forgot there was a biplane section here, genuinely. Same music from the biplane section back in Holland?
You can perform barrel rolls with the circle button. Perfect for dodging those missiles.
Four left. Missed. Oh well. And one more. There you are. First try. They're launching miners? I hope they're over 18, at least.
Oh, that has some sort of shield on them. Your cannon won't work. Fortunately, I've upgraded your plane with a missile launcher. Hold down the L1 button to target an enemy. Then release. The shields are down. Nail that guy before they come back up.
Okay. We can start off at this part then. There's some good checkpointing going on here.
Some sort of shield on him. Your cannon won't work. Fortunately, the shields are down. Nail that guy before they come back up.
That should probably count if they're gonna crash to each other. That should probably count. So it's a little strange that it doesn't count. Fucking kill stealers! A lot of damage when they get when they shoot for them being 20 of them. All right, halfway done. Easier if they stop blowing each other up. Because apparently only counts when I do it. Alright. Oh, come on! Alright, that's 7 left. We can do this. We got this. Oh. I need some more ammo. Alright. Five left, and we're doing getting pretty better. We're getting better at not getting shot. Although these guys are not getting better at not crashing into each other. God, we're not using actual accurate physics for airplanes, otherwise I would have died. And that should be the last one.
That's the last
done. As you do.
Dr. M is plugged into that monstrosity.
Ah, the Cooper is Skyland. So good, so nice. Tiny Felpers likes to play second fiddle. I am the master here. Sidekick.
This is so weird.
That thing is launching sneakers. You'll have to use your missiles to take them out. Save your cannon rounds for Dr. M. It'll work just
I fought Captain Quark, Ratchet, and Clank before. I know how the fight, how this goes. Limit ammo for this section. So I have no reason not to hold the button down. It's not the same fight, but like it's very similar to like the Captain Quark fight, or like if you played Crash Bandicoot, the engine boss fight. Conceptually, it's a very similar fight. Then we have the Crash 3. Simply the Crash 3 engine fight. Well, I better wait for him to finish out before I can keep shooting. Or just hop in and take a couple licks. There we go. Easy.
You and your foolish friends keep trying to beat me with your guns. They're like toys to my creatures. If this whale fly had full cords, he'd laugh at your silly.
Obviously, it's not the same fight as like the Quark fight, the fight, but it's similar in concept where you're chasing a vehicle and fighting it in the air. We don't have a melee weapon for this, so we can't fight this head on.
Hit strong, just like your father.
You don't know anything about me or my father.
Really? Well, who let you in on the secret of this place, eh? Was it my old pal McSweeney, perhaps?
McSweeney works for you? This was all a setup to get the cane.
No, man. Once upon a time, he and I worked together for your dear old dad.
Oh no!
Guy who tried to steal from the Cooper Vault, let alone attempt to kill his son.
Time does strange things to people. Just look at the real leader of your dad, Bentley.
Whatever. We're friends, equals.
Then why is it called the Cooper Gang, you self-centered egomaniac?
That's enough.
He doesn't really have a good answer for that question, actually. Now, I love that Sloan doesn't actually have an answer to that question. Why is it called Cooper Gang and not, like, something else? There's not really an answer to that question, even though it's actually a genuinely good one to ask in this context.
There?
Yeah, pal.
I'm about to head inside the vault, and I want you and Murray to come with me. We're a team, a family. We should do this together.
Okay, be right up, partner.
Nice! We'll have the Panda King give the man a boost! Stand clear, Sly! We're about to get awesome!
This would destroy the van. We don't get a Panda King section.
We're never doing that again.
It's weird. It's surprising we haven't actually played as a Panda King in this.